Frank's Caliwood Specialty. Welcome back to another episode. In this video, we'll be making a 4.5 foot by 8 foot tall storage cabinet. The entire cabinet is made out of 3/4 inch plywood, except for the doors where I used 1/4 inch plywood. If you notice, I flipped over the plywood sheet because I like to reference off of the factory edge against my table saw fence. And of course, always checking for square. Now, I wanted to include this shot here because this is the wrong way of cutting down a long piece of board that is longer than the width of your table saw. I violated my own rule that if it feels unsafe, then simply stop. But nevertheless, I kept moving forward and really carefully, I completed the cut. Ultimately, I enlisted the help of my son to help me on the following cut. And now that we have all our pieces cut, we can begin assembly. Throughout this build, you'll notice I used a combination of pocket hole screws and simple butt joints to join all these boards together. Here, I'm simply notching out the corners for the toe tip. Very important to label everything. I can't emphasize enough how important it is to keep everything nice and square. The first half is done, now I'm moving on to the second half, or the right side of this build. A safe place somewhere in the woods, we can start a fire. All we know is what will be our home. We will stay until the break of dawn. Here, I'm cutting the last piece that will fit on the top of the cabinet. Basically, I started from the bottom towards the top. And again, this is the last section being attached. Of course, I had to cover up and then sand down all the screw holes I had made. Check it out, nice and level here. Wake up feeling the cold in between our toes. Now here, I'm just ripping down a piece for the cabinet toe kick. And of course, gotta glue it up and attach it by clamping it down. Moving on, I'm attaching the backer board, which is a 1/8 inch piece of plywood. And you saw me there show you that I used 1 inch drywall screws to attach it. Maybe a little overkill with the screws there, but hey, more is better. Here's a nice shot of all the shelves of the cabinet. Check this out. This is a way better method of removing clamps. Boom. Now that that's all done, it's time to begin making the doors for this cabinet. I start here by ripping down all my boards. And I'm gonna run a groove through these boards so then I can fit the actual plywood into them. And here I'm just changing out the router bit, which I'll use to make that groove. Now each door is going to have an upper and lower panel, and that's what I'm ripping down here. As you can see, it was a very rainy day in Los Angeles. As you can see here, I'm also using pocket hole screws to attach these frames together. And overkill is the name of the game here. I'm also using some 5/8 inch finish screws. It is at this point that I realized that these doors were a bit too plain, so I decided to add a couple of diagonal pieces to make them look a little better. Not to mention, it also added support and rigidity. Of course, I had to cover up the pocket holes since the outer and inner sides of the doors will be seen. And for this process, you see me busting out my Japanese pull saw to make a flush trim cut, if you will. Don't worry, I did sand the remaining offcut. Up next, I covered all the exposed plywood edges with this 3/4 inch edge banding that I purchased. It goes on very easily, and once the glue solidifies, it adheres very well. Since the edge banding is slightly wider than the thickness of the plywood board, you have to go over it and remove the excess with this edge trimmer. Next, we have to attach all the hinges. I ended up using 4 hinges per door. But first, we have to drill the holes for the hinges. And I used this Craig jig here, which comes with a Forstner bit and allows you to make the holes at the precise spot and at the precise depth. Once I was happy with the dry fit, the painting process began. I painted the doors inside and out and the outer shell of the cabinet. By the way, these are soft close hinges, so they don't slam on you when you close these doors. Thanks for watching, everybody. Another fun build completed.